GNAT Project Manager, Part 4, Qualifiers, Attributes, and Source Filters. To gain familiarity with the project file, let's examine some aspects of Subsystem X Release. The first thing to notice is that the project does not specify a qualifier after the keyword project. According to the documentation, if a qualifier is not specified, then by default it is of type standard. However, by definition, a standard project is a non-library project with sources. Since the default scenario of this project is nothing, which means no sources are loaded at startup, then strictly speaking, it is not of type standard. If we qualify it as such, the project manager will reject it with a message, "No sources found." Therefore, it appears that this project represents a special case. So, the only thing to do then is leave out the qualifier and let the project manager figure it out, which it does. The point I wish to make is that if your project needs to enforce certain rules, then if possible, be explicit and specify the appropriate qualifier. The source tiers attribute is used to specify a list of directories where source code may be found. Although not illustrated in this slide, you should be aware of the fact that the attributes of a project contain values that can be read using the notation project tick attribute. For example, because the project manager implicitly records the directory in which the project was started, we can read this information using project tick project dir. We will encounter an example of this later on. The location of directories which are specified using an attribute are relative to the location of the project file. Hence, the absolute path for object dir is r:/_build. Because these attributes are declared global to the project, they apply to all scenario cases, which means the object files generated in any scenario will be sent to the underscore build directory at the root of drive r. The case statement uses a scenario variable to select a branch. In the case of nothing, the attribute source files contains the empty set. Hence, the project contains no source code. The subsystem case loads all source files and identifies all available test programs in the procedure all main units, which is generated by a script. The main attribute allows us to list all main programs of interest. In the case of subsystem, we use an indirect approach by specifying a main program containing a list of all the main programs known to the subsystem within a procedure that only executes a null statement. If the attribute source files or source list file is not specified, then all units located in the directories listed by source tiers will be found, loaded, and displayed. The mod XML test case introduces the source list file attribute, which identifies a file on drive V that contains a list of all units required to build all main programs specified with the main attribute. Here we see the list of units required to build every test program within module XML. The list of units in the file is generated by a script. There are two kinds of scripts for generating source filters, one for library components and the other for executable components. The source filter scripts themselves are generated by providing input parameters. The first parameter is the name of the filter, which requires two parts: an existing module name, schema in this example, followed by test or EXEC to indicate the presence of main units, i.e. executables. Actually, this two-part name gets the prefix generate and the suffix filter to form an action verb phrase. Examples are generate schema test filter, or generate search radar test filter, or generate search radar EXE filter. Parameter 2 specifies a directory location for the generated script file, which, as you can see from the extension, is currently a PowerShell script. Parameter 3 identifies the script that is updated to include the call to generate schema test filter and to process its output. Parameter 4 provides a list of the main programs. In this example, the main programs are unit tests created for the schema library. The only source filter script invoked from the command line is v:/script gps development update module filter, which takes a single parameter identifying the module and the type of filter, i.e. library or executable. These are the inputs used to produce a script, which when executed will generate the list of units needed to build the DOM library component. A library component provides services that are invoked either statically or dynamically from an executable component, and therefore there is no need for a fourth parameter to specify a list of main programs, as in the previous case. Source filters, which only apply to the release are updated at the end of each development cycle by the Configuration Manager. The filters and associated scripts are managed by the version control system on Drive V. The library components in the XML module are organized into 5 abstraction layers, where each layer depends on the layer below. Hence, Shaman depends on DOM, which depends on SACS, and so on. Because of the structure, unit test and source filter generation activities proceed bottom-up from Unicode to Shema. Anyway, getting back to project files. What we should note here is the use of the library qualifier, the library attributes name, dir, and alidir, and also the ability to reuse attribute information specified in an imported project. Shared projects provide all the advantages associated with a single point of maintenance. The packages compiler and builder in the project Shema lib obtain attribute details specified in an external file by using the renames keyword and dot notation to identify specific packages in the external project. Because of the downward-only dependencies, the source filter for mod XML lib is the same as for Shema library component. That being the case, we can simplify the project file by using the logical OR operator. A source filter is simply a text file containing a list of units. These files are pointed to by the source list file attribute. Note that project files also support the use of the string concatenation operator. As mentioned previously, every main program in a subsystem is registered in a procedure called all main units. Because the script-generated procedure is an artifact of the development environment and not the subsystem, it is located away from the real code in the root of both the release and version drives. The contents of this subprogram amount to nothing more than a series of with clauses and a body containing a null statement. In preparation for the start of a new development cycle, all main units is built from scratch using the release, which has been updated from the version control system with the latest state of the subsystem. This process generates the object, ALI, that is ADA library information, and initialization code in the build directory on the release drive. For large applications, this process could take an hour or more. From the developer's perspective, the subprogram All Main Units serves to verify the build integrity of the subsystem. For example, after making several code changes in various modules, All Main Units is compiled and linked to confirm that the build is not broken. The resulting executable, All Main Units EXE, serves no purpose other than to show it can be built. This file can be huge and should be deleted to save space. It is important to note that in a typical development cycle, more than 99.9% of all units in the release will remain unchanged and therefore do not need to be compiled. Or to put it another way, only those units which have been changed in the workspace need to be compiled. So even in an extreme case where a developer has checked out and modified 100 units into his or her workspace and then issues the command to build all main units, only a relatively small amount of time is required to complete the process, since the vast majority of build files already exist on the release to be used by the compilation system. In addition to saving a huge amount of computing time, another benefit of this development strategy is that a standard issue laptop PC provides sufficient computing power for developers to work efficiently. The only member of the team who needs a powerful desktop computer is a configuration manager. Another service provided by All Main Units is that the files resulting from the build are used by the GNAT binder in the scripts that generate source filters for executable components. This is the end of part 4.